In the today's class, I will give you the introduction about the crystallography, okay, and crystal structure. So that you will see in the previous, in this particular class. So basically, in nature, the matter is found in three different phases. So solid, liquid, and gaseous phase. So three different forms of the matter are found in nature. In solids, you can find two different types of solids called crystalline solids and amorphous solids. Okay, so that's why the crystallography comes in solid state physics. The study of solid state physics includes this crystalline solids also, or crystallography. Basically, crystallography is a study of the crystalline solids. Okay, structure and properties of crystalline solids, that is called as crystallography. Okay, sometimes it is also called as X-ray crystallography, because X-rays are used to determine the structure of the crystals. Okay, so the classification of liquid and gases will not take here. Only the classification of solid based on the structure is considered in this particular section. So solids are classified into crystalline solids and amorphous solids based on the structure of the solids. Okay. And based on the structure, they will have different properties, etc. Okay. Then, what do you mean by crystalline solid and amorphous solid? We'll see. So basically, two types of solids are crystalline solids and amorphous solid. Then what is crystalline solid? The substance is said to be crystalline when the arrangement of units of matter inside it is regular and periodic. Okay. The units of matter may be ions, atoms, or molecules. Okay. If in a solid, the atoms or molecules are arranged in a regular and periodic pattern, then the solid is said to be crystalline solid. Simple example is NaCl crystal, common salt, that is a crystalline solid. Sugar, that is a crystalline solid. Okay. KCl is a crystalline solid. So these are the simple examples for crystalline solids. And you can observe the structure of crystals. They will have certain shape. Okay, cubical shape, some parallelepiped shape. Okay. So they are called as crystalline solids. In these crystalline solids, the atoms or molecules are arranged in a regular pattern. Okay. And they are called as units of matter. Atoms and molecules are called as structural units of the crystalline solids, because the crystalline solids are made up of certain atoms and molecules. Definitely, if those structural units are arranged in regular pattern, then the structure is said to be crystalline solid. Solid is said to be crystalline solid. Therefore, the substance which is having the arrangement of atoms or molecules in regular pattern and a periodic pattern, then the substance is called as crystalline solid. Okay, examples are NaCl crystal, KCl crystal, sugar, different crystals you can observe in the nature. Okay, then on the other hand, the amorphous solids. So in amorphous solids, there is no order in the arrangement of their constituent particles. There is no regular pattern. Okay, so they are smooth. Okay, they are nice powders. The solids in the form of nice powders are called as amorphous solids. Okay. So there is no perfect arrangement. The simple example is the talcum powder. So that is amorphous solid. So it is very nice. Okay. So there is no regular arrangement. You cannot find the shape of the particles there. Group of particles are not in definite shape. So they are very nice powdered form. They are called as amorphous solids. So in amorphous solids, there is no perfect order of the arrangement. Okay. So in order to understand this crystalline solids and amorphous solid, I will take a simple example, a visualized example. Let us take a room, and inside the room, there are 50 chairs, or let us take 100 chairs are there. So chairs are considered to be structural units. So they are forming the structure inside the room. Okay, entire structure of the room is decided by the arrangement of the chairs. Okay. If chairs are arranged in 10 rows and 10 columns, so that the distance between the chairs is equal, Okay, one chair to another chair, there is an equal distance. Next chair is at an equal distance. Next chair is equal distance. So along x direction and along y direction, the chairs are distributed in a regular and periodic pattern. Okay, separated by equal distance. Then that is giving you the example, visualized example of the crystal structure. Okay, if structural units are arranged regularly, periodically, then that structure is said to be crystalline structure. Okay, if chairs are randomly distributed, there is no arrangement, then that is the example for amorphous solid, where structural units are randomly distributed, there is no order of arrangement. Okay, so amorphous solids are having no order of arrangements. And another important property of the crystals is that crystals are distinguished from amorphous substance by their anisotropy and symmetry. Okay, so definitely crystals have symmetry. Okay, what do you mean by symmetry? Symmetry is the definite, that is identical parts corresponding to certain axis or about certain planes. Simple example is a human body. Human body is symmetric with respect to the plane passing through the center. Okay, so left part of the human body is exactly identical to the right part, provided so on the outer body, so that is symmetric. Then another example is butterfly. Butterfly is symmetric with respect to the plane passing through it at the center. Okay, the right wing and left wings of the butterfly are exactly identical. They are said to be symmetric in structure and also in terms of the natural colors embedded in the butterfly's wing. Okay, then another example is the petals of flowers. So flowers are symmetric. It may have 5 petals, 6 petals, 4 petals. Okay, so they're having regular pattern, regular symmetry is there. Similar to that, crystals are also having the symmetric structure. So with respect to certain axis or with respect to certain plane, they are symmetric. And another term called anisotropy is also observed in crystal. What do you mean by anisotropy? The symmetry with respect to x-axis may be different from the symmetry with respect to y-axis. Along x-axis, it may have different symmetry. Along y-axis, it may have different symmetry. For example, you can observe the plantations of areca nuts. Okay, areca nut plantation, if you observe, the areca nut plants are planted so that if you look at the areca nut plants in different direction, they will come along a particular line. You bare point and nint nodidre one line regular fashion alli adana plant madirthare areca nut plantation. Okay, with respect to one direction, you may have different distance of one areca nut plant to another areca nut plant, so that is having one particular symmetry. And with respect to the opposite direction or perpendicular direction, you may have different symmetry, but there is a symmetry, there is a perfect arrangement. Okay, a regular arrangement of areca nut plantations are observed. Okay, so that is a simple example to understand the symmetry and also the anisotropy. Anisotropy means symmetry may be different along different directions. Okay, that is called anisotropy. Cube is a isotropic symmetry. Cube has isotropic symmetry, whereas the rectangular box has anisotropic symmetry. Length, width, height are different. If they are different, then that will have anisotropic symmetry. If length, width, height are same, if you take a cube, cube is having the isotropic symmetry along each direction, so it is having the same dimensions. Okay, and repetition of that cube can be made in order to observe the entire structure. So that is what the meaning of symmetry can be understood. Then you will consider in crystals how these atoms are arranged and what are the important terminologies you need to understand to study the crystallography. So in crystals, atoms are arranged in periodic arrays. Array means it is a group of structural units. Structural units are nothing but atoms or group of molecules. An ideal crystal is constructed by infinite regular repetition in space of identical structural units in the form of parallelepipeds. If you take a three-dimensional structure, let us take the large number of boxes, and those boxes are, let us take, taken as the identical structural units. Okay, boxes are structural units, and these boxes have to be arranged in a particular room. Okay, when the room only arrangement made. So then you keep the boxes one beside the other and one above the other. Melgade nidthavabeku adar side by side kuda nidthavabeku. That is called as a repetition of identical structural units. So identical boxes are kept beside one another, and that is said to be repetition of identical structural units in space. Okay, and that forms the entire structure. Similarly, in crystals, the cubical unit cells or cube structure, that is crystal structure, or some parallelepiped shaped structure can be repeated in space. One beside the other you can keep, and that cell contains number of atoms, number of molecules. Okay, and that is called as basis. We'll come to that later. So that is what the repetition of structural units forms the crystal. Okay, in simplest crystals, the structural units contain a single atom. Okay, these atoms can be repeated in a regular fashion. Okay, let us take large number of boxes are there. That box contains, let us take one atom at each corner to understand it, but large number of atoms are there in a particular matter. But you understand, to understand the concept, you assume a cubical shaped box, and on that cubical shaped box the atoms are arranged so that each corner contains one atom, and repetition of that boxes will give you the crystal structure. So atoms are going to be regularly arranged. Okay, in a simplest crystal, the structural units contain single atom is going to repeated, one atom after certain distance, second atom, certain distance, third atom, like that. And remember, the distance between the atoms is of the order of angstroms. It is of the order of 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So small distance between the atoms is observed. More generally, the structural unit contains several atoms or molecules. Structural units may contain a number of atoms or molecules. A crystal may be composed of more than one chemical element. Okay, example is NaCl crystal, or it may contain associated groups of identical atoms, as in diamond. Example is diamond. In NaCl crystal, the basic structural unit is NaCl molecule. Okay, NaCl molecules are arranged in a regular pattern. NaCl molecule is the basic structural unit, that is the fundamental building block. A NaCl molecule repeat aagta hogutade. Okay, at a certain distance it will be fixed again, at a certain same distance another NaCl molecule. Repetition of arrangement of this NaCl molecule is going to be observed in NaCl crystal. That forms the crystal structure for the NaCl. NaCl is the structural unit. In a diamond, some group of carbon atom becomes a structural unit, not the single atom. Group of carbon atoms will become the structural unit in case of diamond. That's why structural unit may be atom, it may be molecule, or it may be group of atoms. Okay, so that is what the meaning of structural unit is understood in this concept. Then the structure of crystals is described in terms of single periodic lattice, but with a group of atoms attached to each lattice point. Okay, let us understand the meaning of crystal lattice and crystal structure. We'll come to that. And here, structure of the crystal can be described in terms of the periodic lattice. Okay, lattice is imaginary, whereas the crystal structure is real. The group of atoms or single atom structural units are called as basis. Okay, the group of atoms or the structural unit of the crystal is called as basis. The basis is repeated in space to form the crystal. So three terms you have to understand properly: crystal lattice, basis, and crystal structure. Okay, I'll try to explain it. So before that, we'll try to understand crystal translation vector and lattices. Okay. So an ideal crystal is composed of atoms arranged on a lattice defined by three fundamental translational vectors A, B, C, such that the atomic arrangement looks the same in every respect when viewed from any point. Okay. For example, you fill the boxes in one part of the room. Okay. Let us take 50 boxes are arranged regularly in one part of the room. Okay. We imagine the Cartesian coordinate system, the three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system having the axis x, y, and z axis. Suppose you move the entire number of boxes to the second part of the room. Then you have translated the system along certain axis. It may be x axis, y axis, or z axis. Okay, whatever you imagine. So that entire number of boxes are translated. So if you translate that along x axis, the entire structure of the system will not change. Okay, so if you look at the system from a particular point, the symmetry will not change. Symmetry will be as it is if you translate the entire system. Okay, that is nothing but moving the number of group of atoms from one point to the another point along certain vector translation, that is along certain translational vector. Translational means movement along a particular line, okay, by a particular distance. So here, if you move the system from along the vector A, along vector B, and along vector C, they are perpendicular to one another. They are just like x, y, and z axis. Okay. So translational vector is given by T is equal to N1A plus N2B and plus N3C. So it means that this operation, translation operation, if you do that, then crystal is moved by a distance of N1 along the vector A. It is moved along the vector B by a distance N2, and along C, the system is moved by a distance N3. Okay. And here N1, N2, N3 are arbitrary integers. Okay. Where A, B, C are called as fundamental translational vector. Basically, they are giving the dimensions of the basic crystal unit called unit cell. Okay. We'll come to that. What do you mean by unit cell, etc.? So if you shift that from one point to the another point by means of the multiples of A, B, C, then the system will not lose its symmetry. It will be as it is without any change. That is called as the crystal translational vector. Okay, A, B, C are called as crystal translation vectors. A vector T connects any two lattice points. Basically, you are moving the entire system from one group of lattice point to the another group of lattice point. We'll come to that. What is lattice point, etc. The crystal structure, crystal lattice, basically, it is an imaginary concept. Crystal lattice is an imaginary concept. Crystal structure is a real concept. Crystal structure is real. Crystal is real. Whereas crystal lattice is giving you information about the arrangement of atoms, that's all. The crystal is constructed by infinite repetition in space of identical structural units. Those structural units may be atoms, molecules, or ions. If each unit is replaced by a geometrical point, suppose crystals is formed because of the arrangement of atoms. If you replace each structural unit by a geometrical point, imaginary point, you remove the arrangement of boxes and replace it by some markings. One dot if you put in the place of the box. Then that is a geometrical point. It is just like a rangoli. Okay. The result is pattern of points having the same geometrical properties of the crystal. Okay. If you replace the atoms or molecules by means of a imaginary geometrical points, that will give you one structure. That is imaginary structure. And that will show the exact arrangement of atoms, and that is going to be imaginary, and that is called as crystal lattice. Okay, so crystal lattice is group of imaginary geometrical pattern. Okay, replacing if you replace the structural units by means of geometrical point. So definition is very simple. This geometrical pattern is called as crystal lattice, or simply it is called as lattice. The points are called as lattice points. Okay, those markings are called as lattice points. If you define that, the regular pattern of points which describe the three-dimensional arrangement of particles in a crystal structure is called as crystal lattice or space lattice, or simply it is called as lattice. Okay, so here in lattice, there are no atoms. It only gives you the markings where atoms can be distributed. Okay, crystal lattice andre enu, it is a imaginary group of points. They describe the structure of the arrangement of particles in a crystal structure. Okay, I'll try to represent it diagrammatically after completion of the meaning of basis. The crystal structure is formed by associating with each lattice point a unit assembly of atoms or molecules identical in composition. This unit assembly is called as basis. Okay, the structural units are called as basis. Basis is a group of atoms or group of molecules, and they can be put in each lattice point. A marking in madirthiralla, regular arrangement of regular pattern in madirthare, in each lattice point you have to put one basis. Basis may be one molecule or atom, etc. Simple example, in NaCl crystal, NaCl is a basis. That is the structural unit. Repetition of that structural unit gives you crystal. So arrange the lattice points first, then put the basis on each lattice point. Then that will give you crystal structure. Okay, I will explain you in detail. The basis may be an atom or molecule, or it may be group of atoms or group of molecules. Okay, basis may be anything, atom or molecule or group of atoms or group of molecules also. Then if you combine crystal lattice with basis, that will give you crystal structure. The crystal structure is formed by addition of basis to every lattice point. That is, lattice plus basis gives you crystal structure. The crystal structure is real, whereas crystal lattice is imaginary. It is a marking, that's all. For our understanding, to describe the crystal structure, we'll identify what is the regular pattern is there. Okay, so for that, we will imagine the geometrical points pattern. So just I will show you three concepts: crystal lattice, basis, and crystal structure in diagrammatically, and try to understand these three concepts properly. And here in this diagram, this is the crystal structure where regular arrangement of molecules are observed. It's a two-dimensional crystal structure. Regular arrangement of molecules are there. And this is the basis. This is a molecule containing two atoms, that is it. And there is a regular arrangement of these molecules in X direction, in Y direction. So in X direction and in Y direction. And that repetition of arrangement is going to take place. So if you replace this molecule by a geometrical point, that will give you this structure of rangoli. Either rangoli structure, okay, rangoli point. And this is called as crystal lattice. So this is imaginary. So this shows you how does the molecules are arranged in a crystal, or atoms are arranged in a crystal. So this is having the basic unit called a rectangle unit. This is called as basic unit in the crystal. So in this particular crystal, the basic unit cell is a rectangle. Okay, we'll come to that. What is unit cell, etc. So repetition of these points in space, that gives you crystal lattice. Remember, here there are no molecules. These are only imaginary markings. Okay. The regular arrangement of imaginary geometrical points in the space is called as crystal lattice. If you put one molecule in one geometrical point, each geometrical point can be replaced by this molecule, and that gives you the crystal structure. Remember, crystal structure contains group of structural units, whereas crystal lattice is imaginary. It is for our understanding. Okay, so this figure clearly illustrates what is crystal lattice, what is basis, and what is crystal structure. So just I will define it one by one. Crystal lattice is an imaginary group of geometrical points arranged in a regular pattern in space. That is called as crystal lattice. The points on crystal lattice are called as lattice points. So these points are called as lattice points. Basis is a crystal, that is structural unit, repetition of which in three dimension gives you the crystal structure. Basis is a crystal structural unit, that is fundamental building block of the crystal. Then crystal structure is formed by replacing the crystal lattice point by basis. If you put the basis on each lattice point, that will give you the crystal structure. Note the difference between these three. And finally, crystal lattice plus basis, that will give you the total crystal structure. So three terminologies you should remember. Then we'll complete this unit cell in the today's class. The atoms in a crystal are arranged in a periodic array. That already you know, atoms are regularly arranged. It is possible to isolate the representative unit cell in each variety of the crystal. You can isolate the representative unit cell. That is the fundamental building block in space, three-dimensional fundamental block, building block, that is called as unit cell. What is unit cell? This unit cell may be group of ions or atoms, or it may be group of molecules also. And the crystal is constructed by repeatedly translating the unit cell in three dimension. Okay, so definition says the smallest portion of space lattice, which can generate the complete crystal by repeating its own dimensions in various directions, is called as unit cell. Okay, so I will repeat it once again. The smallest portion of space lattice, which can generate the complete crystal by repeating its own dimensions. Remember, here we are not repeating the structural units, we are repeating the smallest portion of the space lattice, the fundamental portion of the space lattice. Repetition of that gives you the total crystal structure. And we have to repeat it, these unit cell in various directions. Simple example you can understand in this crystal lattice. Here, this rectangle is a unit cell. This is the smallest portion which contains four lattice points. Remember here, it contains four lattice points. It is a smallest portion in the crystal lattice. Repetition of this rectangle in this direction, in this direction, in the diagonal direction, that will give you total crystal lattice. Okay. And the dimension of this rectangle is identical. So this rectangle itself is repeating. Take the example of boxes. This box contains eight atoms, statistically. On each corner, there is an atom. Then this box is considered to be unit cell. And repetition of unit cell in various direction gives you the crystal structure. So unit cell is fundamental building block in space lattice. Note the difference between basis and unit cell. Unit cell is smallest portion in the crystal lattice. Repetition of that unit cell gives you the entire crystal structure. Basis is a structural unit, and that may be group of atoms or group of molecules. Note the difference between unit cell and basis. So unit cell is a smallest portion of a space lattice, which can generate the complete crystal by repeating its own dimensions along various directions. Okay. And unit cell can be identified. The structure of the unit cell can be identified by the dimensions of the unit cell and interfacial angles. So unit cell is perfectly defined by using the dimensions, length, width, and breadth. Okay. Length, width, and height, that is called as ABC in this figure. Here OA represents the edge A. OB represents edge B, OC represents edge C. Okay. And they are dimensions of this unit cell. Let us take in a crystal structure. Some unit cell is having this structure, parallelepiped structure. And here you can define the dimensions of the unit cell by taking the length of edges or length, width, and height of the unit cell. And they are called as ABC. They are represented as ABC, where A is the one edge length, B is breadth, C is height, and they are dimensions of the unit cell. And this, based on this ABC and alpha, beta, gamma, where alpha, beta, gamma are angle designated here, angle between this B and C is alpha. Angle between this A and C is beta. Angle between AB is gamma. They are called as interfacial angles. Alpha, beta, gamma are interfacial angles. They are angle between the edges of the unit cell. So based on this ABC and alpha, beta, gamma, you can identify the structure of the crystal. Okay, unit cell is defined using these three dimensions: edges of the crystal, unit cell, and interfacial angles. This ABC define the axis of the crystal. So you can repeat this unit cell in all dimensions, all directions, to get the total crystal structure. And here ABC are fundamental translation vector. So you can replace this, or you can translate this unit cell by distance A along X direction, by distance B along Y direction, by distance C along Z direction. That will give you the another unit cell, and the arrangement will not get disturbed. And that is what the fundamental translational vector are defined by, the value ABC. You can move the unit cell by 2A, 2B, 2C. Okay, that is NA, N1A, N2B plus N3C. It is translating by multiples of ABC. That will not change the entire crystal structure. Okay, so you have to move it or translate it by means of multiples of ABC. Then it will not change the symmetry of the crystal structure. And these vectors by which the translation can be done without changing symmetry are called as fundamental translational vectors defined for the unit cell. And these translational vectors are having the magnitude equal to the dimensions of the unit cell. You remember this. Okay. So this is about the fundamentals of crystal structure. Primitive unit cell we will consider in the next class.